Good morning, student. I am Deepika from DAV Public School, Daudnagar. Today we are going to start the first chapter of history of class 7, and our first chapter is medieval period. What is your first chapter in history in class 7? Medieval period. And at first we have to know that history is divided into three periods. How many periods? History is divided into three periods. First one is the ancient period, second one is the medieval period, and the third one is modern period. When we talk about the ancient period, you have also studied ancient period in class 6. And period from prehistoric time to 7th century CE is known as the ancient period. Period from prehistoric time to 7th century CE is known as the ancient period. But in class 7, we are going to study about the medieval period. We are going to study about the history and civilization of the medieval period in India and the world. And period from 5th to 15th century CE. Period from 5th to 15th century CE is known as the medieval period in Europe. And when we talk about our country, period from 8th to 18th century CE is known as the medieval period in India. And during this period, when we talk about the medieval period, during this period, so many changes took place in the social, economic and political structure of America, Europe and Asia. And when we talk about our ancient period, on that time our country had remained aloof from the outside world. When we talk about our ancient period, on that time. But when we talk about the medieval period, on that time so many changes took place in Europe, America and USA. So that changes, the influences, that changes also influenced our culture. I mean that that changes influenced our Indian culture. And after that, in this paragraph, we have studied about only about, you have to remember, only about a medieval period. And period from 5th to 15th century CE is known as the medieval period in Europe. And when we talk about from 8th to 18th century CE is known as the medieval period in our country. And in this chapter, first paragraph is a period from a medieval period of Europe and in India. And after that, our second topic is sources of information. The main information, the main sources of information of medieval period is literature and archaeological finding. When we talk literature and archaeological finding, when we talk about the literature consists of religious work and commentaries. Commentaries that are based on Smritis and Puranas. And we also get a lot of information about the social, economic, political and military condition of that period. We also get information from a non-religious work. And non-religious work that are based on medicine, astronomy, dramas and stories and other literature. So the main source of information of medieval period is are literature and archaeological finding. And literature and archaeological finding. And also we get a lot of information from a non-religious work. And also we get a lot of information from autobiographies and the orders of the rulers and letters written during that time. Autobiographies, for example, Prithviraj Raso, written by a Chandvardai. And in Prithviraj Raso, all it throws light on the life of the people in North India and also the administration in North India during the reign of Prithvi Raj Chauhan. And we also get a lot of information, literature, religious work, non-religious work, and autobiographies, letters and orders written by rulers, and we get information on that time. In medieval period, Muslim rulers also encouraged writing, historical writings. Tahqiq-e-Hind written by Tahqiq-e-Hind written by Al-Biruni, and Ain-e-Akbari written by Abul Fazl. And many foreigner visitors in medieval period, many foreigner visitors came to India, and they also wrote a travel account. And you have to remember name of foreign visitors. And on that time, Ibn Battuta, Marco Polo, Bernier, also these foreign visitors are also the important sources of information of at that period. Now today we end our topic, and so your assignment is what you have learnt from this session. You have to write 10 sentences about what you have learnt from this lesson and this session. So thank you. Okay, bye.